हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर एस बी कोल्ले, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, शिवाजी आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज कन्नड़, डिस्ट्रिक्ट औरंगाबाद। टुडे वी विल सी रेक्टिलिनियर फ्लो ऑफ हीट अलोंग अ बार। स्टूडेंट्स, यू सी फूरियर इक्वेशन ऑफ हीट फ्लो। सी इन दिस फिगर, वन रॉड इज शोन बाय शेडेड लाइन्स एंड देर इज अ पोर्शन रिटर्न एज HOT हॉट। दिस इज सोर्स ऑफ हीट। दिस रॉड रिसीव्स हीट फ्रॉम दिस सोर्स ऑफ हीट एंड सी हियर, हीट विल फ्लो फ्रॉम हॉट एंड टू कोल्ड एंड। फ्रेंड्स, द वन एंड इज हॉट एंड after some time heat will flow to that cold end. Here you can see two planes P1 and P2 shown by dotted lines. Plane P1 and P2, both the planes are perpendicular to length of the bar. And see, plane P1 is at distance x from the hot end. Also, plane P2 is at a distance x plus delta x from the hot end. Now, temperature gradient at plane P1 is given by d theta by dx. Temperature gradient means change in temperature with respect to distance. Here theta is the temperature, x is temperature above the surrounding of the bar at P1. X is temperature at P2 plane is given by theta plus d theta by dx into del x. Now, temperature gradient at plane P2 is equal to d dx of theta plus d theta by dx into del x. Now, students, heat flowing through P1 plane in 1 second, that is denoted by capital Q1, and is equal to minus Ka d theta by dx. Equation first. Now, heat flowing through plane P2 in 1 second. It is given by capital Q2 is equal to minus Ka d dx of theta plus d theta by dx into del x. Equation second. Now, we have to calculate heat gain per second by the rod between these two planes P1 and P2. It is given by Q is equal to Q1 minus Q2, difference between these two, Q1 and Q2. So, is equal to minus Ka d theta by dx plus Ka d dx of theta plus d theta by dx into del x. If we simplify this equation, we get Q is equal to Ka d2 theta by dx square into del x, because minus k d theta by dx term and plus k d theta by dx term, these two terms get cancelled. So, we get this equation third. Now, we will see what will happen before steady state is reached. Now, heat Q is supplied to the rod. Now, this Q amount of heat is partly used to raise the temperature of the rod, and rest of the heat is lost due to radiation before steady state. Now, heat used to raise the temperature of the rod per second is given by mass into specific heat into d theta by dt is equal to A into del x in the bracket into rho into s into d theta by dt. Here A is area of cross section, del x is the length, and rho is density of the material, s is specific heat. Now, this is heat used to raise the temperature of the rod per second. Now, we will see heat loss due to radiation per second, and it is equal to Ep del x theta. E is emissive power of the material and small p is perimeter of that rod. Now Q is equal to A del x rho into S d theta by dt plus E P del x into theta. We have combined here two equations 4 and 5 because here the first part A del x rho into S into d theta by t is heat used to raise the temperature and second part is heat loss due to radiation. So from equation 3 we can write kA d2 theta by dx square into del x is equal to A del x rho into S d theta by dt plus EP del x theta. After simplification we will get equation 6 as d2 theta by dx square is equal to rho S upon k into d theta by dt plus EP upon kA into theta. Now equation 6 is called as Fourier differential equation. Now students, we will see special cases. First case, when heat loss by radiation is negligible. Here the rod is completely covered by insulating material to avoid loss of heat by radiation. Now from equation 6, d2 theta by dx square is equal to rho s upon k into d theta by dt plus ep upon k into theta. Now this term ep upon k into theta is 0 because we have shown here that heat loss by radiation is 0. So because we have covered the rod by insulating material, so this term is 0. So we can write d2 theta by dx square is equal to rho s upon k into d theta by dt. So is equal to 1 upon h into d theta by dt. Equation 7, here h is k upon rho s, it is thermal diffusivity of the rod. Second case, after steady state is reached, in this case there is no need of further heat supplement because steady state is reached, so d theta by dt is 0, means change in temperature with respect to time is 0. No need to supply heat in this steady state. So from equation 6, we can write d2 theta by dx square is equal to Ep upon k into theta. Here Ep upon k is taken as mu square. So we can write d2 theta by dx square is equal to mu square theta, equation 8. Now general solution of equation 8 is theta is equal to A e raised to plus mu x plus B e raised to minus mu x. Equation 9, here A and B are constants. Now suppose the bar is of infinite length. Now let excess temperature above the surrounding of the hot end is theta 0 and other end is 0. I mean at x is equal to 0, theta is theta 0. So from equation 9, if we put these values in this equation 9, we get theta 0 is equal to A plus B. At x is equal to infinity, theta is 0. So from equation 9, we can write 0 is equal to A e raised to infinity. So A must be 0. So we get theta 0 is equal to B. And from equation 9, we can write theta is equal to theta 0 e raised to minus mu x, equation 10. Now suppose the bar is sufficiently long and is of finite length L. At x is equal to 0, theta is theta 0. Theta by dx is 0 at x is equal to L. So values of A and B in this case are A is equal to theta 0 upon 1 plus e raised to plus 2 mu L. B is equal to theta 0 upon 1 plus e raised to minus 2 mu L. Now solution of equation 9 is theta is equal to theta 0 in bracket e raised to mu x upon 1 plus e raised to 2 mu l plus e raised to minus mu x upon 1 plus e raised to minus 2 mu l. This is the reference I have used for preparation of this PowerPoint presentation. Thank you.